Welcome to Math United. This video is prepared for you to successfully prove trigonometric identities. The tips are valid for any level of questions, but meant specially for the grade 10 worldwide or year 11 of IGCSE or GCSE. So let's get started. First and foremost, you must memorize the identities I'm writing on the screen for you. Some of the systems in the world, they provide you certain identities, but some parts of the world, you need to memorize all the identities and people find them very difficult. So the trick is, do not memorize them at one go. Do what? Whenever you are solving an identity or proving an identity, keep the identities in front of you. You will use them so many times if you suppose practice 50 identities, that they are enough for you to memorize these ones. Okay, so just keep in front of you, keep on using them and you will memorize it. So do not specially take your time to memorize them, but when you use them multiple times, you will get used to them. So these are the four identities I have written here. The fifth one is sine theta over cos theta equal to tan theta. From this first identity, there can be two more identities produced, which is cos square theta is 1 minus sine square theta, and sine square theta is 1 minus cos square theta. If you manipulate this identity, we get this. So these five identities you memorize by practicing, and you will never feel bad about not being able to prove an identity. Tip number two, whenever you have two parts of an identity, left hand side and right hand side, and they have no connection, convert them into sine or cos and you will be able to connect them somehow, because sine and cos are somehow connected to all other trig ratios. Let me give you an example. Here's one. So here we see that cos x is there and cot x is there, secant x is there, tan x is there. All of them are not related. Secant and tan are related but they must be in squares. So the best part is convert cot, secant and tan into sine and cos. So what will I do in this question? I will do this. Cos x over sine x, that is cot x. Next, cos x plus 1 cos x over sine x. And I need to prove it is equal to 1 over cos x minus sine x over cos x. But definitely this one will be simplified to this somehow, definitely. Tip number three, whenever there are two terms of trig ratios are adding or subtracting on one side, and there are one or two terms we are multiplying on the right side, in that case you must convert the two terms on the left side or right side, wherever they are, into fractions, because fractions help us to merge the two parts. So if I look at the first one, tan x is sine x over cos x and cot x is cos x over sine x. Now I can merge them by bringing them together by finding their LCM. So if I multiply this by cos, multiply this by sine and up as well, they will get merged, right? Because they have same denominator and they will become one entity. This will help us to merge them and they will become one term. Let me show you here to complete this one. Sine cos square x over sine x cos x. This numerator is 1 and it will be over sine x cos x. Now 1 over sine x is cosecant x, 1 over cos x is secant x. So there were two different parts adding, we merged them with the help of denominators. Tip number 4, polish your knowledge of the algebraic identities you have learned in previous classes. These will be very handy when you need to merge different denominators or you have to expand something. It will not only save time, but make your work very clean. Let me give you an example. Here is an identity I have to prove. Obviously, there in tip number 3, we talked about if two parts are adding or subtracting, denominators help us to merge them, right? So the same thing we'll do here, we'll multiply the denominators by each other so that the LCM becomes their multiplication. So I will multiply 1 minus cos x here and 1 minus cos x on top. Similarly, I'll multiply 1 plus cos x on numerator and 1 plus cos x in denominator. But look, here it is 1 minus cos x, this is 1 plus cos x, and this identity will be useful here. If you start expanding it, it will not only make your work very confusing, but also you may make mistakes. So memorize or polish them before you attempt identity proof. Tip number 5 and the final one is that if the right hand side is more complicated than the left hand side, then work on the right hand side. There is no rule that you have to work on left hand side and get the right hand side. You can work on right hand side and prove that it is equal to the left hand side. So choose the one which is more complicated and convert into the simpler one on the other side.